One of the new features on the iPad mini 7 that wasn't available on the previous versions is it is now capable of running Final Cut Pro for iPad. I love Final Cut Pro, but Final Cut Pro for iPad? I have mixed feelings. I do still use it though, mainly because it includes a number of features not available on Final Cut Pro for Mac. Let's take a look. First, and this is one of my favorites, is Autocrop. The Autocrop effect automatically reframes clips whose aspect ratio is different from the timeline aspect ratio. So if you have a conventional clip in a vertical project, the Autocrop effect will analyze your clip and then adjust the framing to keep the areas of visual interest, like faces for example, in frame, even when the subject moves. When you add a video to a project that has a different aspect ratio to your timeline, by default, your entire clip is displayed. In my example, with a conventional clip in a vertical timeline, I have these large black bars on top and bottom. We can go to the inspector window, select the transform controls, and change auto resize to scale to fill. This is basically the same as a spatial conform feature in Final Cut Pro for Mac. It scales up your clip to fit the frame. You can adjust the position of your clip to make sure your subject is in frame, but if your subject moves, you have to manually keyframe your clip to follow the subject. You can do this on both the iPad version of Final Cut Pro and the Mac version. But here's what you can't do on a Mac version. Instead of changing to scale to fill, let's leave this set to scale to fit, scroll down to crop tools, and select autocrop. Like it says right here, Final Cut Pro will scan and analyze your clips to automatically keep your subject in frame. This is a 16 second clip, so to show you how fast this is, I'll tap start scan and let Final Cut Pro analyze this clip in real time. Super fast. Now, when I skim this clip, the window moves perfectly with the motion of my clip, keeping our subject in the frame the whole time. I really hope Final Cut Pro for Mac gets this in a future update. Next feature that's only available on Final Cut Pro for iPad is live drawings. And this might be a bit harder to port over to the Mac version, maybe a sidecar feature. Anyways, live drawings lets you draw, highlight, and write directly on footage with touch or Apple Pencil to make handwritten titles, scribbles, and other ways to mark up your projects. To add a live drawing to your clip, move your playhead to where you want your animation to start, and tap the markup button in the toolbar. If needed, move your toolbar off to the side so it's not in the way. Select your drawing tool. You get to pick from a pen, highlighter, or a pencil here. If you tap your selected tool again, you can adjust the line width and opacity of your stroke. Tap it again to close the submenu. Select your color and start drawing right on your clip. Don't worry about the speed or erasing mistakes you make. Final Cut Pro intelligently retimes your animation and cuts out any mistakes you have to erase. Once you're done, click the Done button in the top right corner. Down in your timeline, you'll see a new connected clip. This is your live drawing, and it behaves just like a normal title. So you can move it to a different spot in your timeline or ripple trim it to change the duration of your timing. Keep in mind, making this clip longer or shorter will not affect the speed of your animation. To change the speed of your animation, go back to the inspector window and make sure the format brush is selected. Down at the bottom, we have a draw on time option. By default, all your animation times are set to 2 seconds, but you can speed them up or slow them down by dragging this slider. You can also change the opacity and blend mode of your drawing in this inspector window. Play back your project for a perfectly timed live drawing animation. Without a touchscreen, this feature would be really hard to add to the Mac version of Final Cut Pro. Apple might figure out a way in the future, but as of right now, there's no easy way to do this. If you do want to add hand-drawn animations in Final Cut Pro on Mac, I've made a plugin just for that. Final Cut Pro Animated Scribbles includes over 100 pre-made hand-drawn animations designed specifically for Final Cut Pro. You can add arrows, shapes, letters, number, and much more right from your titles browser and not have to worry about any blend modes, keyers, or masks. Just drag and drop and adjust a few parameters. I'll leave a link for it down below, and I'll also link the video if you want to learn more about FCP Animated Scribbles. Another feature included in Final Cut Pro for iPad that's not in the Mac version is intelligent soundtracks. Final Cut Pro for iPad comes with over 75 royalty-free music tracks you can use in your next project. But they're not just music tracks. Every single one of these music tracks intelligently adjusts to the length of your project. In the top right corner of your Final Cut Pro window, tap the Titles and Effects browser button and select Soundtracks. Scroll through the categories and find a track you want to use for your project. If necessary, download it and drag it down into your timeline. Now, here's what's special about these tracks. If the music track is shorter or longer than your project, all you have to do is ripple trim the endpoint of your track to the same length as your project. Final Cut Pro intelligently adjusts the music track to make it end perfectly at the end of your project. This is really cool. As of today, I think there's about 90 tracks you can use, but by the time you watch this might be even more. Let's hope this library keeps growing. I really wish these features were included in the desktop version of Final Cut Pro, and who knows, one day they might be. If Apple does bring these features over to Final Cut Pro on Mac, or adds exciting new features, I'll make sure to cover it on this channel. Click the subscribe button so you don't miss it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.